teach this young German short-haired pointer memory retrieves, which is the prelude to doing blind retrieves. So start, we've put a dummy out.
Heel.
Going to keep the dog to heel. Now the heel, dog's dropping its nose a bit, so notice I've just got hold of its collar, pulled its head up, because it's off the lead.
Sit.
If the heel work really deteriorates, it will go back on the lead.
Sit.
If it's not ready for this sort of work. Simple, short distance memory retrieve. Lad. So we're just setting the scene with the dog, what we want to do. You notice I'm hissing him as he comes in. He's a bit, dog tends to come running past me, so as he approaches, I'm just hissing at him to slow him down so he comes in and gives me a proper delivery. Okay, so we put the dummy out again in the same place. And we're now going to go a bit further down. This is an exercise you can build during the period of a week or two. Again, but don't let the heel work slip. His nose keeps going down, and I've got to be vigilant, keeping an eye on him, checking the head's not going down.
Sit.
Okay, we've gone a little bit further back now. Settling him down, sit him, point, and send him out. Again, nice and simple, nice straight line, hedge on one side, rough bank on the other. So we've got a nice line for him to follow down. Again, hissing him into the delivery. Okay,
sit.
That's worked fairly well so far. Assist on the sit, get him settled. So just move to run in, pull him back, set him up. It's a memory anyway, so he's not going to be asked to retrieve that yet. So he has to come all the way back with me. Again, trying to keep the head up, trying to keep him close at heel, without nagging him. He's got to do it. But eventually he should just do it. He shouldn't need telling. Wherever I am, he should be at my heel, and I shouldn't have to keep telling him. He should just be there. And when I stop, he should stop. And that's what we're trying to end up with. So I'm not talking to him all the time. But at the moment, just a few little reminders to keep him on track. Again, just turning him.
Stay.
Eventually, he shouldn't have to do all this. He should just be doing it. Again, do a hand signal, send him out.
I lost.
Again,
good lad.
Saying hi, lost. You're in the area. Look for it. Again, what are you trying? You're looking for this nice, clean, fast delivery. Enthusiastic, enjoying it. Still a bit rough around the edges on the delivery, but he's getting there. He's holding it up, he's not dropping it. So we're getting ourselves in a good position. Now I'm going to put two out, and they're fairly close together. So when you're doing an exercise like this, make sure as soon as the dog picks the first dummy, you get on the recall whistle. Otherwise, you could end up with the dog putting that one down and picking the other one if it sees it. So we're trying to keep the dog's mind, whatever it picks, it brings back. It doesn't swap dummies, doesn't think about other things. You can see he's dropping his nose, trying to hunt when he's at heel. Got to keep that right, keep on at him, make sure he does it all the time. Every time his head goes down, try and correct him, just keep his head up. Don't let him carry on, because otherwise you'll end up with a dog that's hunting away from you when you're not looking. See, again, I'm having to remind him quite a lot. There's obviously some scent around there, something's going on, but I've got him refocused and then send him out again.
I lost!
Again, had to pick the second one, that's why I have a slight lack of focus.
Good lad.
So straight on the recall whistle, so he doesn't have a chance to look for the first one.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter which order he picks in. Now he's got to remember there's another one out there. And this is where we're going to struggle. We've got another problem now. There's some geese flying over, so he's going to get distracted. So this isn't what you really need at the moment like this. You need his attention fully, so he's thinking about what else is going on out there. No, he's clean forgotten. There's lots of smells out there. And this is where I've got to make sure he understands what I want. Again, catch him before he goes wrong. You can see he's going to go off course. Keep him out of the rough. Keep him on the short grass. And now I've got to make him realise he's not going anywhere but back. And if you notice, the minute he doesn't go back, I stop him. Don't wait to see what's going to happen and he gets into the bushes where I can't see him. I want to keep him out in the open. Keep his attention and get him back. See, again, he's forgotten the dummy and he's now thinking about what he can smell. He's now taking the back command and I think he's just about remembered. Yep. There we are,
hello.
And we've got a result. He's
good
done
lad.
As he was asked.
Good lad. Come on.
So that's good. A little bit messy, but we got the result we were looking for. Been nice if it had been cleaner, but again, the dog got distracted. Either pack up the exercise or make sure you get it right at very least.
Stay.
Mark. Okay. No, I just want a nice simple finish, just so he goes straight out, so he's absolutely clear before we finish. Just to consolidate what he's learnt. What you're looking for is that nice tight heel. He's got his head up, he's not dropping his nose, he's leaning into my leg, wants to be with me. That's the sort of heel work I like. You don't always get it in these pointers, but you do want to try to get it.
Come. Sit.
Okay, this one's a nice clear hand signal. clear vocal signal. I've asked him to hunt, he hasn't hunted, he's gone too far. Again, a smart response to the turn whistle. Tell him he's in the area again.
And I lost. Found
it. And that's what you're looking for, it's a smart response. Good lad. It makes things so much easier.
Good lad. Come here. Good lad. Sit.
Again, reinforce the sit with the stop whistle. Never miss a chance to reinforce it. Don't nag them with the whistle, but reinforce it.